Hello friends, in this video we will going to learn a new thermodynamic property called entropy. First of all, we know that what is that? See, what is the first law of a thermodynamics? In a first law of a thermodynamics, law of thermodynamics, for a cycle what is that? This is your cyclic integration of dq is equal to cyclic integration of dw, right? And for process, what is that? For process, q is equal to delta E plus W. So this is for cycle and this is for process. And from here we defined a new property called energy of the system right? And it is a system property. So in the when we study first law of thermodynamics, we introduce a property energy, and this is your this is your conservative property. Right, that means we apply conservation of energy. That means energy neither be created nor be destroyed. Only it transfer from one system to other system. So one point to another point. This we study in the first law of thermodynamics. But in the previous videos, we study second law of thermodynamics of TD. What is that? Second law of thermodynamics, for a cycle and for cyclic device. Right? So we study the cyclic and cyclic device. So for that, we apply second law for a process, for a cycle and cyclic device. But when apply second law for a process, what is that? When we define the second law for a process, we defined a new property called entropy. So process defined by the second law through the concept of entropy. That means the process will happening or not. We defined the concept of new entropy. So before we start entropy, our discussion of what is the entropy? Entropy is a somewhat abstract property, and it is difficult to give a physical description of it without considering the microscopic state of the system. Right? So entropy is the best understood and appreciated by studying its use in a commonly encountered engineering process of this is what we indeed to do, right? So in this video, we will first discussion with a Clausius inequality. Right? So which what is that? Which forms the basis of the definition of entropy. So this gives the basis. This gives the base to define the entropy, and continues with the increase of entropy principle. And now we consider the continuous discussion with the increase in entropy. See, unlike energy, entropy is non-conservative property. Non-conservative property. So entropy is the property of the system. Energy is the property of the system. Energy is a conservative property, but entropy is a non-conservative property. That is no such things as conservation of entropy. Right? So when we define the second law for process, we define entropy. And we define defining of entropy is very abstract in matter. So from the base, what basis the entropy will define? The basis is Clausius inequality. And energy, what is the difference between energy and entropy? The main difference of energy and entropy, though this both are the system property. That means these are the system. So this property is defined by a system, but the energy is a conservative phenomena, but entropy is a non-conservative phenomena. So for that, we can discuss further and again discuss further entropy change. Change takes place during the process. Right? Which types of the process? The process is pure, takes place for the process. Takes place during the process for pure substance, incompressible substance, and ideal gas. We define entropy with the process, and the process which follow by the system, and the system is pure substance, incompressible substance, ideal gas. And also we defined a special case of idealized process called isentropic process. Right? Then also we defined the reversible steady flow work and isentropic efficiency of various engineering devices such as turbine and compressor are considered. And finally, entropy balance to introduce and apply to a various system. So we will discuss it is in this manner. Now, see, if we discuss about introduction to a quantitative parameter, see, one observation is that if you have an engine operating in a cycle, a heat engine, which is reversible, and another heat engine operating in a cycle which is irreversible, right? But what is that? Both operating at the same temperature limit, TH and TL, right? We extract a heat QH and deliver a heat QL with developed some work. Right, that work is W reversible. Now, this irreversible heat engine extract a heat QH, develop a work W irreversible, and part of the energy will be lost to the heat engine, to the reservoir. See, when you compare the performance of the engine, that means when you compare the engine, such thing keep into mind, fix such type by fixing, when we want to make a comparison between, so this is important, when we want to make comparison between reversible and irreversible, certain things we would keep in mind. What is that? Keep in mind, certain things we would keep in mind that fix, keep fixed. What is that? TH, TL and QH. When it is work output, and TH, TL and QL, when it is work input, these type of parameter will fix when we compare. That means when we compare these two system, either between the reversible and irreversible, if there is a work output device, so we fix TH, TL and QH. And when this is a work input device, that means refrigerator or heat pump, we always keep in fixed TH, TL and QL. So we are better understand what is the better conclusion and for the understanding of reversible and irreversible engine, right? So as we know that all processes are irreversible. See, we know that all the process which is happening in the nature, all process are irreversible in nature, right? But if we want to compare this, if you want, but this irreversible process will compare to irreversible process, we want to that compare. If we want that comparison between irreversible with respect to reversible process, to what extent? To what extent they deviated from the reversible process? That means if you compare the reversible and irreversible process, so indirectly we compare at what extent the irreversibility will happen as compared to the reversible, right? Can we, for that means if you want to compare this irreversible process, that means irreversible process, that means all natural process, so compare with irreversible process, to what extent they deviated from reversible process, can be stabilized a quantitative parameter. For that, can be stabilized a quantitative parameter. For that, we would be equipped to stabilizing a quantitative parameter denoting the extent of irreversibility. So if you compare the reversible with irreversibility, that means indirectly you compare the how extent the irreversibility will there as compared to irreversibility, then the next we would be a quest for establishing the quantitative parameter denoting the extent of irreversibility. So we compare the quantitative parameter. That quantitative parameter is responsible to at what extent the irreversibility will there in the process as compared to the reversible. See, reversible is the nothing, it is an ideal process. The actual process is irreversible. So for studying the irreversible process, we compare that irreversibility with reversible process. But irreversibility, how much the system process, how much the process will irreversible as compared to reversible, that means how extent the irreversibility will there between the reversible process. For that we are stabilizing a quantitative parameter denoting that extent of irreversibility. And so to do that, let's check what is the cyclic integral of dq and cyclic integration of dq by t. Let's check these two parameters for a quantitative analysis of how much extent of irreversible as compared to reversible. Mind it, this temperature in absolute temperature. So in next video we will check which parameter is a good representation of a quantitative analysis for the performance of extent of irreversibility as compared to reversibility. So we will going to the next video for that extent of irreversibility. Okay, thank you very much.